Please find your way to a seat. There's some extra chairs over to this side if you don't have chairs. The food is amazing, so please don't skip that. I can personally vouch for the pecan buns and the brownie. So does everyone have a chair that needs a chair? And make sure you get one of these beautiful programs that Jordan designed. I want to welcome you here today. We are here to celebrate the life of Jens Otto Gunelson, and also to mourn his death. And we are gathered here from four different communities. Jens' family, many of whom are seated at this table, the University of Wisconsin River Falls, which has provided this lovely space, the Unitarian Universalist Society of River Falls, and also the community of River Falls. And we come here from those four separate communities, but we are gathered around a single God. And just in case you missed them, the bucket hats are to remind us of Jan Gunnison's uniform. We are here because we love him, and he's not with us in a body anymore. We have some grieving to do, as well as celebrating, for grief is the price we pay for loving what is mortal. May we find meaning and comfort by sharing sorrow and joy. May we find inspiration and hope in Jen's many good deeds. And may we find a renewed sense of purpose by gathering here today and sharing our stories. Many of us in this room carry specific memories of Jen's, his boundless generosity, his relentless but quiet kindness. And when I asked myself, what was it like to be around Jens, the image that came to mind is one of the Buddhist images of boundless compassion, and it's a single woman seated in a circle of 1,000 arms, and those whirring arms, including yours and mine, is how compassion enters this world. And Jens was very busy, but he was sneaky. To just listen to the word. We hope that all of you will contribute a memory to the Book of Jens, which we hope to complete with your help. And today we have chosen four people to share their memories of Jens. Jordan Gunelson, his daughter, will be first to share memories of the family. Mark Kinders, a university colleague, will share memories from this lovely campus. Nancy Miller will share memories from the Unitarian Universalist Society of River Falls. And Erin Tomlinson, a longtime friend and neighbor, will share memories from Jen's neighborhood. And I want to ask you to do something, two things. First, to listen with undivided attention, but also to lend your loving support. It's not easy to stand up here and talk about somebody that you love and are missing. The other thing I would invite you to do is let's pause between these stories so that the memories can sink in a little deeper and each of us can remember in our own way what it was like to be with Jens. As we share our precious memories, may we find our own way towards healing. May we learn something here today about living with open hands, hearts, and minds. May we be inspired to live a good life by being kind to our neighbors. I want to leave you with some words of wisdom from the Gospel of Mary Oliver. This is from a poem called In Blackwater Woods. And she writes, "To live in this world, you must be able to do three things: to love what is mortal, to hold it against your bones, knowing that your own life depends on it, and when the time comes, to let it go, to let it go. To love, to hold on, and when the time comes, to let go." Doesn't that sound like homework for a life well lived? And Jordan, why don't you come up and share that?